Does she know you're here?
Who?
Hilary, of course.
Oh, no, she doesn't know me.
So where are you supposed to be?
I haven't thought of anything yet.
So you can send her that then?
No. See, I'd love to, but she doesn't want me. But she doesn't want anybody else to have me either.
Kay?
Yeah?
What was she like in bed?
Do you have to?
Tell me!
Very ordinary. Very boring. She's not like you. She's only interested in cooking and cleaning.
I can't understand women like that. I hate to be tied down by a house. I like to go out, have fun.
No, you don't have to do right for me living with her. It's been like living with my mother.
So don't go back there. Stay with me. Phone her. Tell her.
No, I can't phone her. She hates phones. She's got some phone phobia. The ring gives her an headache. It's best if I don't.
So you can stay the night?
No, I've got to go. As soon as I finish this.
Oh. Oh, you haven't, have you?
I'm sorry, Laura. It's the stress I'm under.
Oh, it's not fair. The least you can do is try to make it last.
Look, I'll make it up to you, I promise.
Oh, it's nothing.
What do you mean, nothing?
It's just a scratch.
Well, how did you get it?
I don't know.
You don't know?
I must have just scratched myself by accident.
How could you scratch yourself? From the top of your neck down to your backside, you can't have done it. It's not possible.
You don't spy on me and tell me what I can and can't have done when you know nothing about it. I just used my right hand for the top half and my left hand for the bottom. My nails were sharp, it was an accident. You don't spy on me and tell me what I've done when you know nothing about it, right? You need to stop harassing me. I'm warning you.
Where have you been?
I just went for a drink.
On your own?
Yeah, why not?
What did you drink?
Bitter, or was it gin? No, bitter.
Who did you talk to?
No one.
What's that smell?
Smells like aftershave. Yeah, it is. It's aftershave.
Why are you wearing it?
Why not?
Well, you don't normally wear it unless you go out.
I have been out.
To the horseshoe? On your own? Hardly a special occasion now, is it?
Well, I fancied a drink. I felt a bit smelly.
Not nervous, are you?
Nervous? Why would I be nervous?
How long did you stay?
About half an hour.
Then where did you go?
Nowhere.
Nowhere?
Nowhere.
Are you sure?
Of course I'm sure. Why would you ask?
Just making conversation. Not going out again tonight, are you?
Well, I shouldn't think so.
Good.
Unless...
Yes?
Well, I might go and see Bob.
Bob? Bob? Who's Bob?
Huh? Oh, he's my mate. He needs some help fixing his car.
Yeah, but you don't know much about cars.
Well, I can haul things for him. Keep him company.
Well, I suppose you want some old clothes to wear on this car.
No, there's no need for that. He'll have a spare set of overalls.
Well, you don't need to impress Bob. He'll be wearing the same thing.
I can wear what I like.
But what would you like to wear?
Just a casual shirt and trousers. We might go for a drink once
we're
finished.
Oh, no, you don't. I'm not washing and ironing them necessarily. You can wear your old jumper and your bell-bottom jeans.
Can't wear those.
Why? What would you like to wear?
I don't know. Just a casual shirt and trousers. We might go for a drink once we're finished on the car.
Oh, where are you going?
Back to the horseshoes.
Right. I'll meet you there, then.
Why? You don't like to come drinking with me and Bob.
Well, what if you asked me?
I don't ask because you don't like to.
Well, I'd like to tomorrow.
Well, we might not go.
Well, you won't need clean clothes then, will you?
Well, we might go.
Well, I'll meet you there then.
Look, we're very spontaneous, me and Bob. If we go, we go. If we don't, we don't. We can't be worrying about what you're doing, Hilary.
How long will it take?
What?
The car.
Oh, I could take some time.
What's wrong with it then?
It's the suspension.
The suspension?
Yeah, that's what I said. Now let me get off.
So, You're definitely going out then?
Yeah.
You've arranged it?
Yes.
You said that you might have to go out tomorrow. Not that you've definitely arranged it.
Well, definitely, probably, he's expecting me.
What if I said I didn't want to go and see Bob tomorrow?
Then I wouldn't go and see him.
I don't want you to see him.
Good God, Hilary! Can't you understand I need the company of men from time to time? Do you have to be so selfish? He's been a good mate to me as Bob.
You know what? I didn't know Bob was so important to you.
Why'd you have to make a big deal out of everything?
Me making a big deal? I'm not the one squirming.
Squirming? Squirming? Why would I squirm?
How the hell should I know?
You've got a screw loose, you. You want to go and get some psychiatric help, and you don't come back to me until you've had it, right? It's like living with a bloody lunatic. I'm warning you, I'll have you certified.
I don't like telling lies. I'm not very good at it.
No. It's not telling lies exactly. It's more withholding the truth. But this is nobody's business but ours. We'll tell her when the time's right.
The time's never going to be right.
But I can't tell her.
Well, I'll tell her.
I don't think so, Laura. She's not like you. She's neurotic.
Well, get her pissed. She'll let it all out once she has a good session. It's not good for your nerves, bottling things up.
I don't think finding out I'm having an affair's going to be much good for her nerves either.
He won't tell you, and I've begged him and begged him. I can't go on like this.
Tell me what? Who?
You probably already know. I mean, you must have known something. We met at one of Sal's parties. He was there. You couldn't make it?
What one of Sal's dudes couldn't I go to? I go to all the Sal's dudes. Sal did not have a do unless I go.
I've come to explain.
Explain what?
Why your husband's been so distant, where he's been, what he's been up to.
Is this some sort of joke, love? Only I've got something burning under the grill.
He's been with me.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I just thought you ought to know.
Look, if you've got something to say, you better say it, then piss off, I'm busy.
Kenneth and I are lovers, and have been for a long time. He won't tell you, so I have.
I'm sorry.
I had to tell you.
This isn't very funny.
I know it's not funny. I'm sorry, I had to tell you.
Look, you're messed up. You're mixed up. You are telling lies. If my husband was here, he'd tell you how much he loved me. If you've got some sort of grudge against him, then this is not the way to go about it. You can't go around making stories, fantasies about other women's husbands. It was the party, wasn't it? You saw me. Got jealous. Because I have a husband and you don't.
I honestly thought you knew. I mean, you must have known something. I suppose you didn't want to admit it. But I think it's best if you do. It's over. Your marriage. Kenneth has been planning to leave you for months.
Right. That's enough. You come to my home. Tell me my marriage is over. Who the hell do you think you are? You don't know my marriage. You don't know what you're talking about. People like you were locking up.
It wasn't all my fault. I wasn't looking for anything. It just happened. I suppose there must have been something lacking.
Right, you listen. If you've come here to say that my husband and I have a crap sex life, then you're very much mistaken. If you come here to say that we don't make it anymore, then you are a liar. If my husband was here, he'd tell you how much he loved me. And all he needs, he gets at home, thank you very much.
He just doesn't fancy you anymore.
We've been married for nearly 20 years. No one fancied each other after 20 years. What the fuck is fancy? We make love because we are in love. Are you thinking of offering him a bit on the side? Flattering his ego. Go ahead. See where it gets you. Anyone can do that. It doesn't make you special.
I'm special enough that he wants to leave you for me.
Leave me? You have got to be joking.
Kenneth wouldn't go with you if you're the last woman alive. I know his taste. I know him. I'm married to him. You wouldn't know that, would you? Because you don't know him.
You'll get over it. I know you will.
Get out.
I'm sorry.
Hi, Hilary, I'm home. What's cooking?
You had a good day at work?
Yeah, not bad. What about you?
I've had a really great day.
Yeah? How come?
No reason, I've just had a really great day.
Good. What's for dinner? I'm starving.
Nothing. I'll make a salad.
How dare you? You have no right. If you just kept your mouth shut, none of this would have happened.
What about me?
Oh, me. All you care about is yourself. She'll never recover from this. Never. I'm going to have her on my conscience forever.
She'll get over it.
Oh, you know her well, do you? We were married. Very happily married till you come along and ruined everything.
You told me you wanted to leave her. You told me you wanted to get married again. You told me that marriage was over long before I met you. And now you tell me I've spoiled everything.
Look, I wanted to tell her when the time was right.
The time is never going to be right. You were lying to her and to me.
I can't believe this. I've been thrown out of my own house and I have to listen to this.
Go and tell her you want her back then.
I don't want her back. How long have we been married? 3 years, and you still can't iron my shirt properly.
Sorry, I'll do it again.
Oh, there's no time.
I don't know why we're going.
Because we've been invited. It's rude to turn down invitations. You've got no manners, that's your trouble.
I thought maybe we could go to the pictures or stay in.
Yeah, and do what? Eat packets of popcorn or one of your messes?
You can take me out to eat.
I am taking you out to eat.
To a restaurant.
And pay good money when we can eat fabulous food for free. Besides, you never eat anything.
That's not the point. It's more romantic.
You see my cufflinks?
What cufflinks?
You know what cufflinks? I've only got one pair.
You're not wearing them.
Why not?
You know why not.
Just give them to me, Laura.
No. You're just being insensitive. I'm not letting you wear something she gave you on our anniversary.
You're being childish.
I don't think so.
When are you going to start acting like a fully grown woman?
I don't like being a woman. I don't like it. I don't like being banished to the kitchen at parties about stupid things with stupid females. Yeah. I want to be where you are with the men. All laughing, joking, drinking, smoking. I want to join in. I can't do the things you ask of me. I'm not like you. I'm not a wife. You do it if you want to. Hire someone. Hire Hilary. Anything to get the pressure off my back. I do my best for you, don't I? It's not like I'm lazy, stupid, or incompetent. I exercise, I try to get my fat bum down and my small tits up. I know I'm no Gordon Blair chef, but I give it a go. The thanks I get. Do you have any idea what it's like to trawl over cookbooks all day? Fantasizing about delicious recipes that I'm not allowed to eat in case I get fat. And even if I could eat them, I couldn't fucking cook them for the life of me because I'm so crap. What happened to me? I was young, sexy, you wanted me. Now I'm a nervous wreck. What have I done? Where have I gone wrong?
You haven't gone wrong. I have. Hilary would never have acted in this crazy way. Now get ready, because we're going to be late. And you better not have a cob on when we get there. I'm warning you.
husband left me, I cried for 16 hours straight. And when I looked in the mirror, I thought, he's done this to you. Him. When your husband leaves you, the word bastard keeps coming into your head. At first, it forms silently on your lips. Yeah, I know. And then you start to mutter it under your breath. And then you start to whisper it vehemently, spitting out all the consonant, and it drums, and it drums, until it builds, until eventually you're screaming, bastard! Yeah, exactly. When your husband leaves you, you know what I mean. There's bastard now. For 19 years of marriage, that's the best thing I can say about him. He's punctual. And there and I, she's come here too. Her. It. They've both come in for dinner. I suppose you better let them in. See you later.
So glad you decided to come. One doesn't like to cook, but one does one.
I hope you haven't gone to too much trouble. We had a lot to eat for tea.
So you're not hungry then?
Of course we are. Starving.
Hi, so I've got enough to feed the 5,000.
Oh, well, now's good, Hilary.
Proof the pudding is in the eating.
I'm on a diet.
Well.
Well, she looks beautiful just the way she is, doesn't she?
Yeah, she doesn't need to diet, does she, Kenny?
No, of course she doesn't.
Oh, I haven't offered you a drink. What will it be, Kenny?
The usual. White wine, please.
Oh, and you, what's your poison?
I'll have what Ken has.
Oh, we're having the same thing. I've got a bottle cooling in the kitchen. Won't be a sec, Lorraine.
Laura!
Whatever.
I don't know why we had to come tonight, Ken. I'm not in the mood for her.
Just keep smiling. You'll be all right.
Everything all right?
I'm getting faceache, Ken.
Just be yourself. You'll be fine.
I can't be myself. She doesn't like me.
Of course she does.
Look at the way she's staring at me.
You're being paranoid.
I don't think so.
You'll be fine.
I will not be fine. It's not like coming here. It's not normal.
Why do you have to overreact, making a big deal out of everything?
I don't make a big deal out of everything. You shouldn't have come. Why can't you say no to her?
Just shut up, Laura.
What's this, a lover's tip? We used to have those at the time, didn't we, Kenneth? We were lovers. Is she always so sulky, so miserable?
No, she's been looking forward to coming ill. Needs a bit of cheering up.
Well, if I didn't know better, I'd say she didn't want to be here.
No, we're both thrilled to be here. Look, it's nice to act in a civilised way, you
After
know.
After the way you treated me. Anyway, I hope your wife feels the same. I wouldn't want to be the cause of any rift.
No, everything's under control. Isn't she looking well?
Yes. Thanks. I always think when people say I look well, they mean fat.
No.
Yes. Well, I'm famished. I'd rather enjoy my food than my figure. Come on, sulky. Cheer up.
What does she mean, cheer up? What does she expect? And what were you two whispering about anyway?
When?
Just then, you were talking about me.
Oh, no, Hilary was just making a little joke.
Well, there's no need to whisper unless you were joking about me.
No, we were talking about someone we used to know.
Oh, great. I didn't know we were going to discuss old times.
Just shut up, Laura. What's cooking here? It smells delicious.
A surprise, Kenny. Something very special. A surprise.
Well, knowing you, it will be extremely palatable.
I hope so. You do both eat meat, don't you?
Yes.
Oh, that's good. I couldn't bear it if you're one of those vegetarians. I didn't think to ask, Kenny. I assume he hasn't tasted tasting food. Only women.
She's staring at me again, Kenneth.
You're being paranoid.
I feel sick.
Look, you'll be fine.
I will not be fine.
Look, she's just trying to make an effort. She's been through a lot, you know.
And I haven't.
There's no need to shout.
Why invite us round tonight? She knows it's special. Why invite us round tonight and you have to say yes?
I love to celebrate me. Any reason for a little celebration. How long has it been?
3 years.
3 years, my. 3 whole years and you're still together. How long did we last?
19.
Is that all? Still, you must be pleased.
Fucking thrilled.
Laura, sorry, Hilary.
Oh, don't apologise for her, Kenneth. Let her be herself. Anyway, a toast.
to the happy couple on their third wedding anniversary, to Kenneth and Laura. Cheers. Cheers.
Do you need any help with anything?
No, everything's going according to plan. What are you going to do?
What?
How are you going to help her?
I don't know, that'd be up to Hilary.
Well, you haven't been in the kitchen before, so how could you possibly help her?
Well, just as long as you don't go anywhere near it, we'll all be safe from salmonella.
Ken doesn't like my cooking, Hilary, but has always spoken very highly of yours. Oh, that's nice to know. We've all got to be appreciated for something. Peanut, anyone? Ooh. Perhaps I could put a record on, as if I didn't know what you wanted on, Kenny. How about Elvis? I mean, you do still like Elvis, don't you? I've still got one of your CDs in the back.
It's grown out of Elvis, if that's what you mean.
Oh, surely not. You haven't, have you?
You don't grow out of Elvis, Laura. You grow into him.
Although I've tried and tried, she's never been able to understand the finer characteristics of Presley's songs.
There's none so deaf as those who will not hear.
You don't know what you're missing, Laura. Partying with Kenneth's middle name. When he danced, the whole room shook and the CDs jumped. When he told a joke, he laughed louder than anyone else. And well, when he had a few too many, we all ran for cover. His all-time hero was the king himself, Elvis Aaron Presley. And he never let anyone forget it. Not Kenneth, not my husband.
Not this bit. What's the delay?
She won't just be throwing things together in there, you know. She'll be doing all the business.
Well, it'll be time to go to bed when it's time to eat.
Well, if you're bored, you can go home.
You what?
Call a taxi and go home.
And leave you here with your ex-wife.
Yeah, what's wrong with that?
It's our bloody wedding anniversary!
Oh, it's no need to shout.
Dinner should be too much longer. Any minute now.
Why don't you put a CD on, Ken?
Hurry up, Ken. Ain't got all day. I've got to check the oven.
It's on.
I don't suppose you told you how we met.
No, I never asked.
How boring, do you remember? You looked at me, and it was like my heart started beating for the first time.
I smiled at her and she nodded, and asked if I could buy her a drink.
And remember, he gestured, do you want a drink? And I indicated I had enough. And when they played Elvis.
And I held her tight.
He held me tight, and he looked handsome.
She looked all right.
And we kissed.
I think I'm gonna grow up.
Not now, Laura, please.
The bloody times I've had to listen to how great you were, how wonderful. It's hard to imagine he threw you away like a piece of dirt.
Laura, shut up. I'll kill you.
Did you hear that? He's going to kill me. Me, his wife, the woman he loves.
Actually, he didn't throw me away. I threw him out of my house, even though he pleaded with me to stay. Isn't that right, Kenneth?
Who all those peanuts?
Well, I wish you'd let him stay. I wish you stayed together. I wish I never laid eyes on either of you.
Don't listen to her. She's just had too much to drink. Needs something inside her, you know.
Oh, of course. You must both be famished. Is it naughty of me to keep you waiting like this? The famine before the feast.
I'm sure it will be. But what are you cooking? A slow casserole?
Instead, you spoil your appetite.
Nah, I'm alright. I'll have another drink though.
And I will.
No, you won't. You'll sit there and you'll keep quiet.
Dinner is served.
Thank Christ for that.
Eat it, Ken. Don't stay here. Let's go home and I'll rest you up some egg and chips. You know you like egg and chips.
Not yours, I don't.
Oh, come on, Ken. Let's go.